Okay, here we go. Let's go now.
Hey, everyone. I'm Mark DeRosa.
Thank you.
keeping this top of the second alive. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And that one right down Main Street. A wave at one around the shins with no luck.
In today's game, if you're not disciplined for striking out, why would you change your approach with two strikes right here? Expect this guy to try and drive the baseball right here.
Stays alive, still 0-2. Bases are empty here with 2 men out. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Swung on and missed. Outclassed by that fastball for a strike. Bogarts on at first. Nobody out. And really stretching out the at-bat as he steps out for a second time. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. And now here's the third time he stepped out. Talk about breaking up a guy's blitz. They really bunch him up on that, but if he swings and misses for the first out.
So here's how the Phillies are positioned defensively. And let's take a look at first baseman Carlos Santana. Originally came up from the minors as a catcher, also has dabbled at DH, but don't get it twisted, this guy can handle first base as well with soft hands and big time power at the plate.
First delivery to him on the way. A swing and a miss, he's behind the big curveball. One, here's the pitch. Fastball right back to the mound. Now the second for one on the first, and that's 2 innings. Welcome back to Fenway Park.
base hits, first and third, nobody out.
Yeah, and you just got to prepare yourself as an offensive player. You're just trying to get the runner in from third. You can't worry about creating a monster inning. Do your job.
First pitch coming, here it is. Clear on wing of the miss and a ball down.
From a hitter's perspective, you knocked the donut off your back, don't you? Two things. This pitcher is out on the mound looking for a strikeout or a double play. So you better set your sights at least that high.
As a look, now the pitch. And he couldn't get him to chase the 0-2 fastball. It's 1-2. Runners into scores here. Nobody out. In center, here comes the runner from third, and they'll add another as this is now a 5-0 game. Digging in once again, Nick Williams. He's 0-2 in the ballgame so far. Here comes the first pitch, and it's fouled away. First with two away. High fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2. Step out and ask for time. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Plunging at that one out of the zone, and that's strike one.
Wow, not sure what that was, but talking about having your mind made up, you're going to swing before the pitcher even throws a pitch. I don't know how you swing at that pitch.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
Thought he looked like a caveman swinging a club on that one. It's 0-2 now. Two things pitchers really love.
here at home plate as he asks for time. Now the pitch. In there, the base hit. And they're able to get the ball in quickly, so he'll be held to a single with one away.
Gotta be a little frustrated on the offensive side. Yeah, everybody's getting knocks and the batting averages are flowing right now, but nobody's come up with that big runner in scoring position, two out knock kind of feel that really is going to break this game.
Riding in once again, Stephen Wright. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. To the at-bat. Swing and a miss just behind a lively fastball. And now he'll again ask for time. One thing you don't want to do is get a pitcher too riled up out there. Vasquez stands at first with one out. To the left side, backhanded, and now against his body, a jump throw, and he'll beat the throw to first despite a fantastic effort, and that ought to be scored an infield single. Now, boy, there's a quality infield base hit right there. That kind of reminded me of the old Yankee shortstop, Derek Jeter, on that jump throw. Hey, that's why this is the pros. Back in the day, that's a knock all day long, but up here, guys are making those plays, at least making you think about them. That's an amazing play by the shortstop to leave his feet and at least make this close.
In
now, Cesar Hernandez. Straightaway center. Wright is in pursuit. He's got it, and there are two down now. And he will scurry back to first as he'll think twice about trying to move up. Here's the center fielder, Odubel Herrera. He scored after reaching on a single in his last time up. On its way is pitch number 75.
Something going, and the last thing you want to do is fall behind.
Oh, hold on, what a stop. He gathers the throw. It's there, he got him.
Big league play of the
bring up Evan Marrero.
Swing and a liner. Taking it over at first for the second out, and that might have been extra bases if it were 3 feet higher.
There's the first baseman now, Mitch Moreland. A hit in 2 tries so far. Down by the home plate umpire. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Swing and a miss and a ball down.
This offense is going to have to find a way to get going. It's happened in the past where every team goes through and where everyone seems to fall into a funk at the same time. Everyone needs to relax and not try and be the hero. Just start getting the leadoff guy on.
Crawford is there, and they breeze through this half inning. Welcome back to Fenway Park here in the great city of Boston. It's on to the seventh inning now with the Phillies out in front, and it's a good time to check out our game summary through the first 6 innings so far. First delivery to him on the way.
Went about halfway there, but it's a cold strike regardless.
Well, this has been a lot of pitches for him out of the bullpen. As you can see, they're asking a lot of him in this one, so I won't be surprised if he gets a day off or two after this one.
Now a ball hit high in the air, deep down the line in left, looking just a little, and it's off the Green Monster. And the Phillies are able to get things started with a leadoff double.
No doubt about it. He was looking fastball all the way there, and that's exactly what he got. He got the barrel out front and just blasted it down the line for an extra base hit. Nobody out. Runner in scoring position. Great opportunity here.
Standing in now, Reese Hoskins. Liner in there for a base hit. Sits him. Rounds third and is digging for the plate. He comes across to score. They force their lead to 8 now.
I mean, that has to feel good right there, Dan. That's the third RBI in the game that extends his team's lead. They might have this one locked up.
Well, I'd say those are always big, those add-on insurance runs.
Big RBI right there for a little bit more breathing room.
Oh, he just blows the fastball by him for strike one. He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. This is on the ground over first. One there. On to Moreland, but it's too late, so they'll get just for one.
That's a really difficult turn for a first baseman when you have to come get the ball, make a strong, accurate throw. So you need two good throws, not an easy double play to complete.
Into the box now, Mike Hilberger. Takes a cold strike at the knees. It's 0-1. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Hey. Back ball called for strike two.
One ball, two strikes.
Here comes the nothing and two pitch. Got him looking with the fastball as that had some two-seam movement to it. Two gone.
Yeah, I can't disagree with that, Matty. He's allowed a couple of runners to reach here in the inning, and the command just doesn't seem to be there anymore. I got to think they're going to turn to a bullpen option very soon, if not right away.
Strike one to start the at-bat. And a fastball in the dirt is taken for a ball.
He's certainly giving up plenty of hits in this one, but the funny thing is he hasn't walked anyone yet. That tells me he's throwing strikes, but he's just not throwing enough quality strikes.
One and two now. Popped him up. And he'll get under it and put it away in foul territory. So now it'll be the fourth ball of the club Pomerantz. That's one for two in the ballgame.
Starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally.
First offering on its way. There's one out and missed. Outclassed by that fastball for a strike. And now maybe a mind game or two going on down there as he steps out a second time in the AB. Two on his line so far in the game. Now he'll step out of the plate and reassess things here. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Swing and a miss way behind the big fastball.
That swing had one purpose, and that was to put the ball over the wall. I guess he doesn't have much to lose with his team down this many at this point in the game.
Oh, and one count and the pitch. And on the ground now to second. Hernandez has it. Throw on to first. Two gone. Into the box now. Frank Kimbrel. And then it seems like this starter is just dominating the game right now. Feels like we're seeing a lot of three up, three down innings.
No doubt about that, Matt. Hey, I've enjoyed watching him go about his business, but I'm also interested to see if this offense can figure out a way to get a couple of cracks in his armor before it gets too late.
Yeah, that remains to be seen. And maybe trying to get him off stride at the plate so he'll step out and ask for time. First pitch of the at-bat. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. This now is in the second, and he has another one. He does. Eight in a row, he sent down, and the side is retired. In order to go the Red Sox, they're on the short. they'll go ahead and intentionally walk the lead off bat. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Cesar Hernandez. He flew out in his last at bat, shot weakly to the left. There's one. Well, he'll put this in his pocket and be content with just the one out. So that one wasn't quite hit sharply enough to turn two.
Yeah, choppers like that make it really tough. You can't make the ball get you much faster, so the key is making sure you field it cleanly and at least get one, which they did there.
Now batting, Odubel Herrera. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Breaking ball. That's in the dirt, and he takes the ball. Hernandez, the runner at first, with one gun in the inning. 2-0 to the Phillies center fielder. Thornburg is about as stingy as they come in terms of a bullpen arm. He's proven very difficult to hit, and it's a rarer thing still to see multiple hits against him.
Yeah, Manny Dean, if you wonder why it's so hard to score off of this guy, he's nearly impossible to get three or four hits in an inning to score a run. He keeps his walks per nine inning is really down, and you look at his hits per nine inning pitch, it's no wonder why this guy's one of the top relievers in the game right now.
Well, that's not a real good look when you flail at what ends up being a wild pitch. Doesn't say much about your pitch recognition, but regardless, the runner is able to advance, so we'll see if he can drive him in now.
Here's the pitch on 2-2. And a fastball blew it right by him. Two down.
That's just quality pitching right there for that strikeout. As we look at all five pitches, notice the location. All five down in the zone. Some guys are real good low ball hitters, but more often than not, keeping the ball down is going to lead to a lot of success on the mound.
So now Carlos Santana. Misses 2-0, it's ball one. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. 1-0 pitch. Swing and a miss just out in front of that fastball. Digging in to try it again, Christian Vasquez, a hit in two tries so far. Now time granted here at the plate as he'll step out of the box. First offering on its way. Hit down the line of third. Bluff by Santana, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Stepping up now, Stephen Wright, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one.
a fine line for working down in the zone on 2-2 and bouncing one in there that basically stands no chance of getting swung at. Right there, he basically spiked that one right into the dirt, and now he has to find the zone on a 3-2 pitch.
Now at the plate, Nick Williams. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-4 day. And this one's in the dirt. And no advance, it's ball one. The 1-0. Fastball that misses.
Boy, not exactly what you'd like as a pitcher. One of the keys is to minimize your pitches, attack the strike zone early, a lot of deep counts, and working himself into a lot of trouble.
In the dirt, and now let's see. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. And that's going to wipe away the possibility of a double play as the runner moves into second.
Well, now might be a good time to make a visit to the mound. Your pitcher walks the first batter and allows him to get into scoring position with the wild pitch. Got to settle him down and make sure everything's all right physically.
Pete Embry comes on to pitch now, hoping for better results than the other arms that they've run out there in this one. To corral this quickly as the runners hold on. Pronto ahead with a 3-1 countdown.
I love the approach out on the mound. Everything's down in the zone as it should be. Now you find yourself in a 3-1 count. You elevate a little bit more and get back in the zone. That's a big no-no. He obviously had to work carefully with two men on, but he did not want to walk with the load of the base. Now he's really got his work out for him. We'll see how he fares here.
Aaron Altair is the batter now as he looks at a ball of 1-0. Bases loaded here, nobody out. Now it's 2-0.
Putting himself in a pretty bad situation now on 2-0 and the bases loaded. He basically doesn't have much of an option but to challenge him right here.
Settling in now, and he's got ducks on the pond, as they say, looking to add to his team's already sizable lead. Now a 1-0, misses ball two.
If you're hitting in this situation, you have to look once, and that is all. This guy's really scuffling out on the mound. The bases are loaded, 2-0 count, it's all over the place. One spot, if it's not there, you have to take.
To deliver on 3-0. Slider's in for a strike.
Well, he had big aspirations behind that swing. Pretty obvious he was trying to put four runs on the board in a hurry.
And that misses ball four. A run will come in the score.
Thank you.
but it's a full count now, 3-2. Swing and a miss got him reaching. He'll make it back in safely at third.
Pretty textbook breaking ball for the punch out right there. Got it to bend a lot, and by the time it got there, it had fallen completely out of the zone. Not much you can do with that pitch.
Here's Carlos Santana now. Batting left-handed here as he takes a look at strike one. He's sent packing on strikes in his last trip. One ball and one strike to the Phillies' first baseman.
You know, he just doesn't have command of where he's throwing the ball right now. I mean, that pitch was supposed to be on the outside part of the plate. And when you miss by that much, something's off.
Keeping it down here as it's 1-2. Inside and hair low. It's two balls and two strikes.
Classic back foot slider right there with two strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there.
Full count, 3-2. A 3-2 hit. Count still full, 3-2. Three runs already home here. Ground is good. A play at the plate. And the runner scores from third as they extend their lead.
And those are plays that cost you all games. You're already losing, and then you make an error like that to compound things. That's how things snowball on you, and you start to feel like you can't do anything right.
And that will bring up the Sacramento product. Bruce Hoskins, ball one to start the at-bat. Four runs here in this at-bat. Deep on the strike. Getting a little jumpy in the box, so he steps out and asks for time. The pitch. Liner toward right center. We'll add one to his total of that ball game. He's got three hits in this one. And a nice job to get the ball in quickly. He'll be held to a single here with nobody out.
Zero, not a bad night. Three singles, but hey, he'll take 3-4 every day of the week.
Yeah, today's day and age, Dan, where everything's a homer, a walk, or a strikeout. It's refreshing to see this guy throw out three base hits. And that will bring up Devin Marrero. As he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty at strike one. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Boy, sure taking a sweet time down there at the plate. He'll step out yet again. Betts gets his lead at first, nobody out. Swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
Looks to me like he's trying to make adjustments pitch to pitch up there at the plate, but he's looked completely thrown off so far. Late on the first one, way out front on the second.
Santana is there, and that's the first out of the inning. Next up for the Red Sox, Mitch Moreland is working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Now, time asked for and granted by the home plate umpire.
Yeah.
pitch of the at bat on its way. Presentation of MLB Network. So long, everybody.
Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 31 minutes. Our Fenway Park table tennis presenter is perfect.
for one pitch in one spot. And if it's not in that spot, you take it.
Now a check swing here and a little looper. 3-2, here it is.
Wait, and he pops him up
over toward foul territory. And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one. So Revere set down to open things up, and with that, let's take a look at the Red Sox defensively. It's brought to us by Majestic. So the bases are empty with one man gone, and stepping in is the catcher, Carlos Ruiz. Anthony Barbaro is on, and he'll take over on the mound. Carlos Ruiz takes it at the plate, and boy, a high strike ball there. That's not all that consistent, but it's strike one.
That was the right call, and looking at it again right here, I don't know if I can tell for sure either. We'll wait to see what the guys in the dugout say after reviewing this play a couple of times, probably.
And that's a thumbs up from the bench, so they will challenge the call on the field. So the umpires on replay duty in Manhattan will now review the play from all available angles in order to make the final decision.
So here's one last look at the replay. There has to be indisputable evidence in order to rule the runner safe. And boy, I'll tell you what, I just don't see it here. I'd be pretty surprised if this challenge works out for him in this case.
And the review process appears to be coming to an end, so here comes the decision. And he's indeed out at first as originally called, so they lose the challenge. get a break from playing the field and be the DH here in this one.
Yeah, it's a nice luxury to have here in an interleague ballgame. You give them a little bit of a break from the field, but you still keep that big bat alive.
And a sliding attempt at first for this sneaks by in the base hit. Brady Sizemore will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner in first. And that's in there for a strike.
And you know, if you're going to challenge a guy up in the zone with a fastball, why not do it on the first pitch? A lot of times it's going to be taken anyway, and you just find yourself a strike that you can now throw anything off of.
Castillo will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Hanley Ramirez will start things off in the bottom of the second. Now, time granted here at the plate as he'll step out of the box. First pitch coming. A late swing here as this is hit hard to the right side. This is foul for the first strike. And now maybe a mind game or two going on down there as he steps out a second time in the air. And now pitch on the way. Swing the ball hit hard on the ground at first. And the big fella just takes it to the bag himself for the first down. Pitch. And that one is swung on and lifted out to Revere in center field.
game.
trying to bunt at a pitch that it's not even close? I'll tell you how bad. Real bad.
First pitch coming. And there's the fastball by Hamels. Good for strike one.
Well, as we've seen so far, this isn't a team that's going to wait around too long to feel a pitcher out. They're an aggressive team all the way from top to bottom. And if that first pitch is anywhere close, both of these guys are going to take a hack at it.
Brown is there, makes the catch, and the side is retired. Nothing across here this half of the inning. Brady Sizemore will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth. Fastball in there for a called strike. Pitch on the way. Grounded foul off to the right side. Now the pitch. This ball is grounded foul. Here's another 0-2. And swung on it, sent on the ground to first. And he'll take this with a bag of three unassisted for the first down.
Give this guy some credit. He's been able to hold the fort since he came on early. He kept his club in the ball game, and that's all he could have asked for.
Cody Ashy will try it again. Set down on strikes his first time. Now the first pitch. In there, no balls and a strike. Two runs on two hits, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. And this ball's heading for the seats down the right side as the count will move to 0-2 now. That misses, says the home plate umpire. 1-2. Where it misses, I'm not quite sure. Had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Now another 1-2, and he just manages to stay alive here as he fights this one foul. Here he comes again, 1-2. Fouled back. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. And the third baseman will have a look at it, but this is back into the seat. Another 1-2 delivery. And he couldn't get on top of it as this has popped up behind shortstop. Under it is Bogaerts, and there are two away now.
Well, this will wind up nothing more than a pop-out to the scorebook. But what won't go unnoticed in that dugout is that he battled for an awfully long time. That takes a lot of energy out of a guy when he's got to throw that many pitches.
Freddie Galvis will dig in. He singled his first time around. And that's in there for strike one.
A lot of pitches for him out of the bullpen, as you see there. You gotta wonder how long they'll wait till they pull the plug.
Now here's the pitch. And that's swung on and fouled straight back. Here comes another 0-2. He goes the other way, and this is hit well out toward deep left field. And they'll pull this one down a step or two in front of the warning track, and the inning is over. Hanley Ramirez. And in to start things out here in the home half of the fifth. And you get the sense, Steve, that this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame at this point.
Yeah, they pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon. Not a lot to get excited about so far. And I think that's a credit to that man out there on the mound. He's cut right through this lineup for the first four innings.
Here's Hamels back at it now as the first pitch is swung on and missed for strike one. The pitch count there, one pitch into his fifth inning of work. Not much of a concern, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, it should be. He just had a real overtime inning to go. He should be fine.
Throw over by us, they won away.
Boy, you talk about a guy getting himself in the group. How about 10 in a row he's retired? You're making it look easy.
Maybe trying to get him off stride at the plate so he'll step out and ask for time. Line hard to center field. And a diving effort at center, but it's going to skip right on by him. And the Panther's going to try for three. And he will make it into third with a one-out triple.
Well, you can kind of give him a little bit of a pass here because he's such a good defensive center fielder. The hits this one all wrong. And as a result, he's going to allow his man to make it all
And that will take a moment.
started it.